Hi friends, in this tutorial we'll see how to configure Spring Boot security and make use of the default login and logout page provided by Spring Boot. For this I'm going to take reference of my website javanews.com. So go to Spring security section. The example that we are going to see is Spring Boot form security login hello world example. I'll be sharing this URL along with the YouTube video. In a previous example we had developed Spring Boot security hello world application. You can go through this example here. So here we had created a simple Hello World application. In this tutorial what we are going to do is we had again in a previous example created Spring Boot form handling example. So here we had seen how to do form handling using Spring Boot. We are going to provide Spring Boot security to this application. So in this series of Spring security we are going to keep on adding the Spring Boot security features one by one to the Spring Boot form application that we had developed. In this example what we are going to do is we are going to make use of the default Spring Boot security login and logout page. In the next we'll be creating a custom login page, then adding JDBC authentication later on, and then authentication handler example. Also I'll be adding more topics to this Spring Boot security. For example we are even going to see how to enable CSRF and what is the use of it. So let's proceed with this example, Spring Boot form security login example. So you'll be requiring the source code that we had developed here, Spring Boot form handling example. For this go to this example and below you'll find here the source code Spring Boot form handling. Download this example and import it in Eclipse. It's a Maven project. So we have imported this project in Eclipse. Start the application by running the Java application. Our application it has started successfully. Next go to the URL localhost /get employees. So this was the form application that we had developed. So it has three pages. One is the home page, the other is the add employee page, and the next is the show employees page. So in the add employee, if we add suppose emp123 employee name and do a submit, then we can see that it is showing here the employee that has been added. So we'll be adding Spring security to this application. Security, it has two aspects. One is authentication and the other is authorization. Authentication is whether you're going to be able to log in to this application, whereas authorization is once you have logged in into this application, should you be able to view that page? Do you have enough rights to perform that operation? So in this example, we are going to see both authentication as well as authorization. We'll be creating two users. One will be JavaNews and the other will be employee. So the employee will only be able to view the pages home and show employees, whereas the add employee page will be accessible only if the user is JavaNews. So the JavaNews user will only have the authorization to access add employee, whereas the employee user will not be able to access the add employee page. So let's see how we are going to do this. So this is the Maven project. In the Maven project we are going to add one more configuration class, that is the employee security configuration.java, and that is the only Java change that will be done. So let's do those changes. The first change that we are going to do is we are going to add the Spring Boot starter security dependency in the form.xml. Next we'll be configuring Spring security. So for Spring security configuration we'll be specifying which URLs are to be intercepted and to be accessed by which users and having which roles. Also we'll be creating users along with the passwords and specifying them a role, so which will specify which pages can be accessed by them. So as I told previously, we'll be having a username JavaNews and the other will be username employee. JavaNews, it will be having the roles user and admin, whereas employee will be having the role of user. So the pages that will be accessible to JavaNews will be all the three pages, whereas employee will not be able to access the add employee page. This will be because only an user with admin role will be able to access the add employee page. So employee does not have the role of an admin, so it will not be able to access the add employee page. So let us first see how this security configuration is done. We have created an employee security configuration class which will be extending the web security configurer adapter. Also the annotations configuration and enable web security will be used. Next we have overridden the configure method here. In this configure method we have specified that Spring Security should not be applied to URLs matching slash resources. This is because all the usually the CSS related and jQuery related libraries, they are all having URLs which are similar to slash resources. Next we have overridden the configure HTTP security method. In this method we have specified that in order to view a particular page, user should be having which roles. So let's see how this is done. Initially we have specified a permit all, which means that no filter should be initially applied. Then we have specified that for a user to visit the welcome.jsp page which is having the URL slash welcome, the user should have at least one of the roles, that is of a user or of an admin. Next for get employees, again either a user or an admin role will do. For add new employee, the user has to have an admin role, so only Java in use which will be having the admin role will be able to access it. Here we have not specified any specific login page, so a default login will be used. Also we have disabled CSRF. We'll see what is CSRF and why it is disabled in the future tutorials. Next, in the configure global method, using the in-memory authentication, we'll be creating user employee with the password employee and having the role of a user. And also we'll be creating another user Java in use with the password Java in use and having roles as user as well as admin. In the future tutorial we'll be using a JDBC authentication instead of the in-memory authentication. So let's create this configuration class. So this is the only Java change required. The other change is on the JSP side. So in the JSP side, we have a menu.jsp page. In that we are going to add an additional menu where we'll be specifying the logout link. So the logout link, it requires the method as post. So let's add this. Go to source, main, web app, webinf, JSP. And here we have the menu.jsp. So in the menu.jsp we'll be adding the logout link along with the post submission. So these are the only changes required. Next let us start the application and see if it is working as we expected to. The application has started successfully. So if you'll go to welcome link, it asks for a login. Now if you put any wrong login with the wrong password, it will say bad credentials. Now suppose if you put the login as employee and the password also is employee, we are logged in successfully. Also we are seeing here the logout page. Now if we go to here, add employee, see it is not allowing us to see the page because it doesn't have this authorization. If we go to show employee, it will show us the page correctly. Also if we go to logout, we'll be able to log out successfully. Now let's again go to welcome and this time we will log in with the username javainews. Yeah, we are able to see the welcome page. Next we'll do the add employee. Yeah, you will be able to see the add employee page also correctly. Just do employee and again suppose employee only. Also we are able to see the show employees page also. So our application is working as expected. Do a logout and we'll get logged out. So it is working good. I hope you have understood this tutorial. The source code for this, it can be downloaded from here below. Thank you.